The reason we really want to get you on the show is, can this be fixed, technologically speaking, in the short term?
Yeah, it actually can. So there's a few different approaches to handling the different ways that people are going to be using these systems. And one is to have a bunch of different models under the hood that end up figuring out what different users' intent is and providing different kinds of responses based on what the user intent is. So it should be fixable. I'm a little surprised it's taking so long, but I guess we'll see.
What I'm trying to reconcile in my mind is that Google is at the origin story of artificial intelligence, the body of R&D or academic work that happened more than a decade ago. How do we get to this point where they publish a tool where there is clear evidence that the model has some deficiencies and evidence of biases?
Yeah, I mean, we've seen Google laying off a lot of people, laying off people who are experts in AI ethics, which really helps with the kinds of issues that they're seeing now. I think that Google might be playing a bit of catch-up, sort of trying to release things perhaps before they're fully ready, and also not necessarily having the right people at the table to make the decisions. So Google's in a very different position than it was, 20 years ago.
It's worth saying what side of the table you're coming from and your history with Google, because, of course, you co-led Google's ethical AI team. You stepped down from that group. You're previously, of course, over at Microsoft. I mean, you've been everywhere. You've moved over to Hugging Face to really drive the ethical perspective at that particular part of the business. But I'm interested as to the lackings, the failings that you saw a couple of years ago that drew your criticism, and ultimately, as you left Google, is that what's at edge here? When I think about some of the issues that you say as to why this isn't getting fixed as quickly, it seems to be, from your perspective, a question of personnel here and who's got the power to make decisions.
Right, yeah, it's completely an issue of who's at the table. I mean, one of the things that so many women and people of color speak to in the AI ethics world is the need to think about how technology is going to be used, how it impacts different people, and we're really not seeing that kind of consideration in the way that these technologies are being unrolled. So it really seems to be that there isn't enough clear thinking about foresight, about context of use, about the social impact. And these are things that a lot of people who specialize in things like AI ethics, responsible AI, many of whom are underrepresented in technology, we're not seeing this kind of insight, which means that there might not be the right people, and the people there might be more disempowered than they should be.
And the model that this is then unleashed upon is in an environment of a culture war, as some might call it, Margaret. I'm interested, though, what, for me as a consumer, could be made clearer? How can prompt transformation, how can me understanding what's going on under the hood be better served to me so I understand where I perhaps can show my preferences, my needs, my choices when it comes to the images being generated?
Right. So one thing that actually people are familiar with Google image search is when you type in some sort of query, some prompt to get a set of images, there's a bunch of different boxes you can select from that get at different things you might use. In the past, Google has actually been very good at this, trying to give users an option to specify the kinds of intents that they have in what they're trying to search for, and then further refining based on that. So that technology is there. It's something that Google actually has a history of developing and developing well. This same kind of approach could be put into any sort of chatbot system, be it more generative or not, where users are shown a selection that they can choose among to get at the kinds of things that they would like. There's also the possibility to have a back and forth in order for the system to ask the user for a little bit more specificity. Users could potentially set preferences, and the system could also show a variety of different things, regardless of different boxes users might check. They could say, here's a historical image, here's the world as it could be, let me know more about what you'd like to see.